number six. I want to know more about my Lord.
In this world I
grace on the last verse. We'll come in altar for altar prayer.
Bless you. Bless you.
Towards the end of it, how where Nebuchadnezzar began to say, "Blessed be the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who sent an angel, to deliver his servants." Amen. So, So you know what? Tonight, reason them was sent because they trusted in Him. They trusted in their Lord. Tonight, so you know what we're going to have to do? Just trust in Him. He'll come right on time. You can't force Him to come. Hey, man, you can't make Him up. You just got to allow Him to come. Many times that we've seen it around here, it seems like, well, we're just about ready to give up. We just get out of the way just long enough. And here He comes. Through somebody that was willing. To refuse to see them. So you know what, Mike? I'm willing tonight. I really am. I want to be willing tonight for His name's sake. I really do. I hope the Lord blesses you for this way. If you're here tonight, you're lost. Why, you're in a good place. You really are. Amen. You could leave here tonight a whole different creature. Amen. You certainly can. If you're here tonight, you just ain't where you need to be.
That's right.
Just move up.
That's right.
That's all you can just do is just move close to where the Lord is. And He'll bless you. He certainly will. We've got something on your heart, something you want to do or say.
Marty, I have meter quiz. Like I said, thank God for God to me and thank His house.
Amen.
Thank God for the day.
God bless your heart.
Marty, it's good to be here tonight. Most of all, it's just good to be saved. You know, I got some news before I came up here. This young lady that is Brandy, one of Brandy's real good friends, and a little girl that I've known since she was a teenager, they found out she's got leukemia. I just remember her in your prayers.
God bless you, man.
You know, sometimes I don't know how people deal with this if they don't have God to help them with this kind of news. You know? To be honest with you, when you get that kind of news, it's shocking to you to start with. But then if you just let God comes in and He'll shift His calm things down. You know, it's not that you don't care, or it's not that you don't hurt. But you got somebody to take that hurt away from.
That's right.
If you don't have Him, there's nobody to take the hurt. You just have to bear it all by yourself. You just turn it over to Him.
Yes.
Because He can handle it.
Amen. He really can't,
but He can. Just remember her in your prayers. Got a little girl that's the same age as KK.
God bless
you. I'm sure that family's tore up.
I'm sure they are.
Just
a little bit honored to remember them. It certainly would this evening. Because it might be your family or my family tomorrow. See the same news, brother. Lord, I hope to depend on the old Mother Church to cry out on my behalf. Amen. I tell you, with that prayers and through God, you can get through anything. Through this walkway of life. But it takes Him. God bless you, Mike. Somebody else. And something on your heart. Come on, Father.
I was driving to work this morning. I don't ever have a radio. I just like it quiet.
Come on.
I look at the blue jeans and they got a hole in the knee. And I think, well, you know, I probably need to put a patch on that or something, or it's just going to get worse.
Come on.
I get people involved down the road and I start thinking, you know, it went that long ago in my life. I got a hole in my life.
You know, yeah, 28
years, I guess it was.
Yes, Lord. Tell it, boy. Come on, Pop.
You know, I patched it, but.
Listen.
Didn't know nothing about church. Until I walked through them doors to their vacation Bible
school. Yes, listen. God bless your heart, Pop.
I met a man that's always.
Amen.
Right. Yeah. Wow. You know, I work with a lot of these kid in here. I've worked with Marty 24 years. He told me before I ever started coming to church. I ain't proud of what he used to be. I'm pretty proud of
the
man.
Amen, Paul.
I've seen that in them blue jeans this morning. It wasn't for me. It's for somebody.
Anytime he wants to take me, I'm ready.
Amen.
I
his hand.
Praise your Lord.
Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord.
It's your house. I'm living in.
A whole bunch of men and women in it. They were all standing in line. And at the front of that her heart.
She told me today that right now she's getting in trouble to ask to come to church.
Bless her heart.
And honey, yeah, God, please pray for her because in our family, because she's just getting in trouble to ask to come to church.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord. believe some of us is in trouble, brother.
Right.
Come on, boy.
I believe somebody needs to get in.
Yeah.
Come on, Josh.
You pray for us just for a little while.
We'll do our very best, brother.
I know you are praying people.
God bless you, boy.
I know that I've never stood behind this desk when I didn't feel the prayers of God's people.
Come on, bless
We surely desire those tonight. We've got just a little bit of scripture reading on our heart. We're a little bit lengthy, but you bear with us. We're not a very good reader. We've had this message for a while, and it seemed like as the service went on, we got more nervous and more nervous and more nervous. That's when I know I need to do something.
Yeah,
I get nervous.
Yeah. Yeah.
Amen. Amen. Chapter 6, the book of Joshua, if you want to turn there.
Bless you, Lord.
Verse number 1, chapter
on,
6,
brother.
The book of Joshua. The Bible says this in verse number 1. Now Jericho was strictly shut up because of the children of Israel. None went out, or none came in. And the Lord said unto Joshua, see, I have given unto thy hand Jericho, and the king thereof, and the mighty men of valor. And ye shall compass the city, all ye men of war, and go around about the city once. Thus shalt thou do 6 days.
The seven
priests shall bear before the ark 7 trumpets of ram's horn. And the seventh day you shall compass the city 7 times, and the priests shall blow with the trumpet.
Come on.
And it shall come to pass that they make a long blast with the ram's horn. And when you hear the sound of the trumpet, all the people shall shout with a great shout.
Come on.
And the walls of the city shall fall down flat.
Amen.
And the people shall ascend up every man straight before him. Joshua the son of Nun called the priest and said unto them, take up the ark of the covenant and let 7 priests bear 7 trumpets of ram's horn before the ark of the Lord. He said unto the people, pass on and compass the city, and let him that is armed pass on before the ark of the Lord. It came to pass.
Come on, boy.
Amen. When Joshua had spoken unto the people that the 7 priests bearing the 7 trumpets of ram's horn passed on before the Lord and blew with the trumpet and the ark of the covenant, and the Lord followed them. And the armed men went before the priest, and they blew with the trumpet, and the rearward came after the ark, and the priest going on and blowing with the trumpet. Here's what we want to look at tonight, if God will be our helper. Amen. And Joshua had commanded the people, saying, ye shall not shout nor make any noise with your voice, neither shall any word proceed out of your mouth. Amen. Until the day I bid you shout, then shall ye shout. Amen. You might be seated. Amen. Would you pray this for a few minutes? Amen. We first introduced to Joshua. We know, us Bible readers know that, amen, that he took Moses' place as the leader, amen, of God. We know, the Bible says that Moses died, and amen, God had done chose Joshua, amen, to fill his shoes. And the Bible says that one day they came up to the Jordan River there. Amen. And the Bible says that God said, I'm fixing to magnify you, Joshua, in the eyes of the people. Amen. And God done just what he said he'd do. Just like he always does. He always does what he said he'd do. He's never left me just yet. And I'm persuaded that he's going with me all the way, even to the end of this world. I've got a friend that'll stick closer than a brother. And when I'm looking death right in the face, I've got somebody there with me. I don't have to get it on, amen. I can stare it right in the face and tell it ain't got no power on me, amen. Because I've been saved by the grace of God. Amen. The Bible says that Joshua there, that God had a little meeting with him. He done told Joshua, he said, I'm going to give you everything that the sole of your foot touches. He said this, I'm going to even give you Jericho, that big city, that city that they were scared to death to conquer. Amen. Amen. The Bible says, amen, that God told Joshua, Joshua didn't tell them they was going to conquer it. He said, you just do what I do.
Yeah.
Amen. And Joshua being there. Right. Amen. They got up early. Yeah. And they went down there to Jericho. Yeah. Amen. They began to walk around that city. I don't know why. Amen. That they had to walk around her 13 times.
Right.
Amen. But I got to thinking. Amen. That brother in my heart began to talk. Him, amen. Lord have mercy. Amen. Joshua said this. He said, I don't want a word that to come out of your mouth. Well, because he knew what kind of people he was dealing with. He was dealing with those that complained and murmured and talked against him. And he didn't want to hear it. Hinders the work of God.
Yes, sir.
Oh, yes. Amen. Yes. Appreciate you, brother. Now that hinders the work of God when we murmur and we complain about our leaders. Amen. Amen. But listen, I've got one leader. I can't speak for you. And his name is Jesus.
Yes, come on.
The only one I've got. Amen. But listen, Joshua said, I want you to get down here early. I don't want you to say a word. I just want you to keep your mouth shut. Amen. And I want you to march around that city. Amen. And history tells us that them walls was 40 foot tall and 6 foot wide. And Marty, I could just see them as they walked around them walls. And Jericho, them men are sitting on top. Amen. With their bow and arrows and their spears and whatever else they had. And them people walking around that wall. I'm thinking, what in the world are we going to do? Oh, we're outnumbered. Amen. We're outnumbered on all sides. And this wall is massive. But nevertheless, I'm just going to shut up and let God will do what God does.
Yeah, come on.
Dude, 7 times. Amen. 7 days. And on that seventh day, they went around her 7 times.
Yeah.
Amen.
Come on, God.
7 times. And Joshua said, all right. Now when you hear that trumpet blow, amen, you shout. Amen. I'm telling you this. As they walked around it, I'm sure they finally got to the point out of where they said, there's absolutely nothing in my power that I can do to this wall. Woo! But I've got somebody I can shake the foundation. Woo! And it'll fall flat. You can't get help until you're at your last.
Amen.
That's it, bro.
7 days long. They marched around that thing. I believe God wanted them to do that. That way they knowed every square inch of it. They know there was no breaches in it. They know there was no cracks. They know it was impossible by themselves. And when God answered, woo, something happened. That wall fell flat. They had to show up. That was the first thing they had to do. They had to show up. You notice what the Lord told Joshua?
Come on, boy.
He said, you gather them men of war.
Yeah.
He was talking about his own people.
Yeah. Yes.
They'd never fought a battle in their life.
No.
They would just come out of Egypt. They got out of the wilderness, just crossed the river. They'd never fought a battle.
Come on, boy.
And God called them men of war.
Right.
Children of war.
Yeah.
You're more powerful than you think.
Yes.
Amen.
You've got the most powerful thing in your possession.
Yes.
If God ever saved you, you've got it.
Amen.
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 You've got it tonight.
Yes, sir.
You don't need nothing else. You don't have to look anywhere for the patch. You've got it. Amen.
Yeah.
God's not just a patch. He won't just fix a hole in the butt, patch a hole away. He'll fix the hole.
Yeah.
He said, God,
come on.
You men of war. He said, get them men of war.
Come on, God.
them children of war. He classified his own people as children of war. Amen. And I believe he's classified you and I as children of war. And because every single morning when I open my eyes, I have to look that old devil right in the face. And if I ain't careful, I'll go with him.
Yes, sir.
God. Amen. But listen to me. I've bought him many a barrel. Amen. And I'm going to tell you this. If the Lord turns his coming, I'll have to fight some more.
Amen.
Because I want everything that God wants to give me today.
Yes.
Amen.
Bless it, Lord.
You see, they walked around seven times. And on the seventh day, they went seven more times.
Yes,
or six, seven times. 13 times all together that they walked around that wall. Amen. So I said all that to say this. Amen. You and I, in our life, amen, and possibly in your life's like mine. And when you set your mind to do something for the Lord, you better look out. There'll be a wall pop up somewhere. Amen. It might even be your wife or your husband or your kids, but there'll be a wall that Satan has put up on a trying to distract you.
Bless you, sir.
That wall try its best. Amen. But I want you to realize, just like these, I'm just like the children of Israel. It takes me forever to realize that I have no hope within myself. My hope is in the Lord. My hope is in His blood. Who in glory and mercy? I've faced many a wall, and I'll face some more. But let me tell you about one wall. Woo, that I've already conquered. Woo, it's dead. It ain't got nothing on me. I'm going on.
Amen.
Amen.
Bless you, Lord.
Yes.
Let me tell you, I'm going to have to face a few walls. I know.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Lord, Terry's here coming. But the biggest wall in my life has already been defeated. That big wall of death. Amen. When I die, when that angel comes down and he grabs me and escorts me into the bosom of Abraham, I can look death right in the face and say, you ain't got no business here. I've been covered by the blood. Amen. Jesus gave his life. Amen. That I might have life and have it more abundantly. So you listen to me tonight. When I was a little lost boy, I know that death was certain. I know it was coming. Amen. And I was scared to death. I didn't get it. Amen. To even go to sleep at night. Because it seemed like something that was unconquerable. And certainly it was within myself. But that morning I went down to the altar. The very moment my foot come off the ground. Amen. I seemed like I'd marched around her. Woo, 7,000 times. But when I started that way with God, woo, she fell flat.
Amen.
And it don't worry me no more.
Amen.
Bless you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
It fell flat.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Come on.
Bless you, Lord.
See, they had to show up.
Yes.
They had to show up to march.
Bless your heart, George.
Next thing they had to do is have to show up.
Yeah.
You know good and well. You know good and well this right here will get you in.
Yes, sir.
I just let the Lord. You see, when you ain't talking, as they was walking around that wall, they wasn't talking about fishing. They wasn't talking about deer hunting. They wasn't talking about the bad day they had at work. They couldn't say a word. They just had to think.
Thank you, Lord.
Just had to chew on a little while.
Yeah.
I can just imagine my little feeble mind.
Oh, yeah.
How in the world is the Lord going to do anything with this?
Yeah.
Nevertheless, I'm going to keep walking around it. I don't know how far it was around here. I didn't look at that. But I know them walls is 40 foot high and 6 foot wide. And it's absolutely a monstrous wall. Had the guards on there. I done told you they were outnumbered.
Yeah.
Hey, man, but Lord, don't matter how many you're up against if you've got the Lord.
That's right, brother.
What else do you need?
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
What else do you got to have?
That's right, brother.
Sometimes we ought to march instead of murmur.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
We need to march a little more instead of murmur.
Yeah.
That's an extra there. Sometimes we just need to march instead of murmur. Because the more we murmur, the more we get somebody else out of shape. And before we know it, we're all out of shape. Amen. And we don't know which way to turn. If we just took directions out from Joshua and them being a type and shadow of Jesus, if we take our direction from him, amen, and those impossible walls, and those sicknesses, and those diagnoses of cancer, and we just take them to God, amen. He'd make those walls fall.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Hey, a little story.
Come on.
This how confident you can be.
Come on.
If you've been saved by the grace of God. He doesn't say death's coming. He's coming to me. Amen. I might not never make it back to be rich. Lord have mercy. You come to my funeral and cry, I'm liable to get out of there and smack you. I ain't going to be there no way.
That's right.
The rich man was died and buried and in hell lifted his eyes.
Yeah.
Amen. But it don't say nothing about Lazarus died or going to the grave. He bypassed her all because he had Jesus.
Amen.
Let me tell you a little story. It's true, by the way. Amen. This is how confident you can be. Amen. If you've got the Lord. Amen. My daddy was diagnosed with cancer. Amen. He laid there. He done real good. I got up to about 8 weeks before he died. And he woke up one morning and he couldn't eat nothing. He's sick in his stomach. And he laid there for 8 weeks and never eat a drop or bite of nothing. Absolutely shriveled away. I took nothing. Amen. It was about 4 or 5 weeks in. Amen. I hope and pray that I could be this strong. Amen. I was sitting there one day. Amen. Glory, hallelujah. I'm being my uncle. And he was laying there on the couch. And he raised up. And he began to vomit. And he said this. He said, I'm telling you what's the truth. There ain't nothing no worse than getting this close to death and can't die. He had a bear hug. I hope and pray if I'm in that shape, and he meant every word of it, I hope and pray I'm the same way. I hope and pray I can just say this is this plumb term. I get this close to death and can't even die. Amen. Hey, I'm not lifting my daddy up. Amen. But there's spirit in that place. Now when he said that. Amen. But you know what? Them people had to show up. And they had to shut up. And they had to march. And listen, now here's key. Amen. As they marched around, they didn't know how many times that Joshua was going to ask them to march around there. But they had their ears attentive to what Joshua had to say. If we ain't got our spiritual ear attuned in to the gospel, attuned in to Jesus, we can't hear, amen, what he's got to say. And my pet ball, amen. Hey, when I was a little boy, I'd get a little rambunctious. I'd get a little hard hearing. He'd say, I believe you're getting hard of hearing, son. He'd say, I'm going to have to clean your ears out. Amen, through your hind end. Amen, you know what? It's all right, amen. And we take us a good spiritual ear cleaning. You know, woman. And because those without chastisement are bastards and not saved. I despise not the chastity of the Lord. I count it all joy. Amen. When you fall into diverse temptations, for the trying of your faith, it worketh patience. And let patience have her perfect work. Amen. God's good. Not just sometimes. But all the time, God's good. Amen.
right.
Jesus, when he gives you the command,
yeah.
Sometimes you know what a shout can be.
That's right.
That's right.
Yeah. I see it, brother.
He can give me this.
Yeah. Yeah. Come on, brother.
Sometimes it can be this.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah.
Yeah, thank you for saving me.
Yeah.
Forgive me for what I've done.
Yeah.
Oh, the list goes on and on.
Oh, yeah.
You know what you need to do.
Yes.
I don't have a clue.
No.
But I know there's a wall in your life.
Bless
you.
Bless your heart.
Immovable.
Yeah, it's good.
You can't go get a D9 and fly it out of the way.
No.
It's a wall. Amen.
That
only the Lord. There was nothing on the planet that could move that wall. But when God's people came together.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
The New Testament says, come together in one body.
Oh, yeah. Bless you, one Josh.
Yep.
One core.
What's that?
You remember when Paul and Silas had been doing their very best?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Preaching the gospel.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Been doing their absolute dead level best. I believe that they was really on fire.
Yeah.
And then the old Romans, I believe it was, come and got it.
Yeah. Bless your heart, boy.
And they handcuffed them. Threw them in the maximum security, the innermost part of the prison.
Sure did. Yeah.
And they had them fastened in stocks.
Yes.
Amen. And you know what your shout might be? Hey, you know, Paul and Silas, I can't read where they was communicating much at all, if any. But the Bible says at the midnight hour, the darkest hour, they began to sing praises to the Lord. And there they was, handcuffed, and their feet in stocks. And the Bible says that the earthquake, that it shook, listen now, that it shook the foundation of that prison. And all the walls, all the doors blew open, and their fetters loosed on. Amen. They shouted when God said, shout, and what had them bound, let them loose. Amen.
Amen.
Bless your heart, boy.
Amen. God can make the earthquake.
Amen.
Who would have thought? And no, you know what? I'm sure they wasn't a bunch of church-going people in that prison.
No.
Probably the most ungodly people you imagine. Guarantee you they was drunkards. If they had pills, they was pill poppers. They was smokers. They was whatever you want to say in that prison. They was mean, probably murderers. Everything in that prison.
Yes.
But they decided they'd just go with God. Right there, fast in stocks. Maybe old Paul come out with something like this. Once again, I face Satan this morning, and I battle him all the day long. But in my weakness, God sent breathing for my
hands.
And now I sing big. The sun's coming up in the morning. Every tear will be gone from my eyes. This old place's gonna give way to glory. And like an eagle, I'll take to the sky.
Come on, brother.
He's already invited you to come.
Yeah.
If the Spirit says come, come.
Yeah.
He that has ears to hear, let him hear.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
I want something like God for it, peace. You know, the first thing that crossed my mind when you was talking about them being put in that inner sanctum of the prisoner, it went back and it made me think about what it is like nowadays. They call it, you know, they call that, where they come in there, solitary confinement. So they can be around them. But yeah, but yet God, whenever he, when they turn loose, everybody in the prison hurt. I thank God for it. I thank God that I know that I'm saved.
Amen.
Thank God for that man.
Yes. Hey, Art, just come.
Yes.
Hey, man. If you don't ever move, that wall will still be there.
Yeah.
It surely will.
Yeah.
Yes, it is. Thank you, dear Lord. Man, I can just see it.
Yeah.
I really could, Randy.
Yeah, I'm right.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Lord.
All right, we got to work a little early. They really don't want us doing a perfect inspection until 8 o'clock. So I pulled over and there's like, I don't know what kind of a store it is over there. This morning, I had my Bible in the passenger seat. Pulled over and started reading about them all.
Bless you, Lord.
If I'd have to get up, I'd have to put scriptures on my heart. Nehemiah, he said he'd come in with a sad temper to throw the key. But you know what? The key
come
asked
on,
him, he said, what's the matter? He had to pray to God, look for it first.
Come
on. You know what? I know the story.
Yeah.
But he went over and he got the grace. He took everything he needed. But there was men over there talking. He said it nice. He got up and he started at one place. He walked around and sat there at one place that the beast that he rode on, he couldn't cross. So he went down to the brook and he got up and better look at it. And they still walked him. But you know what he had to do before the wall fell? Before they could build the wall back and build the gates back, they had to clean the rubble off
first. Yes, yes.
I had to get it down to where they was at. I started thinking when Dad did construction, sometimes they'd let us go to work quick, and you know what my job was? When they started putting them walls up to sweep everything out from underneath it. That way there was nothing in the way.
Yeah.
And they brought that wall back up that it would be as strong as it could be.
Yeah.
To make sure everything was out of the way.
Bless
you know, I can't take nothing away from the 2 men that's done for each of them. We give you a hard time today. Said, how in the world can you get up after what's done been done? I listened to the message this morning on my way to where I was going from last night. I said, oh, I can't be them men, but help me get everything out of the way that I might be able to be my little self. So I heard everybody say it a lot.
Amen.
She asked me one time, said, what's on your mind? I said, oh, you can't do it. Because I don't know how to explain it. And I said, right here. And I glorified myself. I said, Lord, let us get everything.
Yes.
Just plumb out the way.
Yes.
It's got to be.
Yeah, come on.
With a heart desire.
Yes.
To get everything out of the way.
Yes.
You know, just talking about seeing just a picture. I saw a picture that said there's no greater faith than a man that planted the crops and his hope from grow up. I'm going to tell you about a faith that's 10 times stronger than that would ever be. That I was told about a man.
Right.
He wouldn't save my soul long
enough.
Right. I was an 8-year-old little boy, I didn't know nothing. I thought I did a lot of time though. But I took the church praying for me.
Yes, it did.
Give me the light. Right. Give me the knowledge of what
yes,
I need to do. I don't know what is standing in the way. It's talking about sickness, it seemed like. This week and this month, we've had faced more of it than anything that ever time that I've ever been in. And a lot of people don't know that they diagnosed with ALA, with leukemia and liver disease. And then Robert called me.
Yep.
And they told me that they couldn't do nothing for him. When they keep coming back to getting everything out of the way.
Yes.
Well, now I had to give up up swinging. They said you'd never be able to do it again. We thought, well, there's no way. But you know what? To fight this, she quit. She's not had nothing. She's not even looked at nothing. She was serious about it. She put it out of the way. If we want to see somebody saved,
yes.
We need this up as a church. Right. We better be ready to get it out of the way. Last night we went to make some sacrifices.
Yeah.
And now we've heard about the men being dedicated and walking around. And now it's our turn to be dedicated.
Yeah.
Get a little bit out of the way. I use that altar. I let him know about it. And when I leave, I pick it up and put my hand behind my back. And I go back and run. That's not out of the way.
No,
if I keep bringing it and don't have the faith that he can sit right there and take it from me, then I shouldn't have came in the first place. But I had to get my heart right and say, Lord, I need you to take me. I told Sam, and I'll shut up. I told Sam, I said, I got the phone call the other day and went and visited Robert. I said, Sam, I'm sorry. I said, I get so tore up about finding the house and everything, and I start wondering why. But then I look at this, and look at the situation that these people are in.
Right.
And then you start looking back. I've been saying there's nothing. Even the home we buy, I'm not going to be in it for very long. You're talking about going home, being there. I know we had a conversation in Sunday school. They asked. And I did my very best to explain it. I'm not going to be nervous right at it. I'm not going to know my wife is my wife. So I'm thankful what I got is an 8-year-old boy. I'll be known by. I've done the best. And let people see just exactly what it was. I thank God that I can get everything out of the way. There's a connection there, and I'm thankful. I know this is just a second night. I'm thankful for me growing. I've got to do it myself. From what I've heard, I'm thankful they've come in and give me exactly what I need.
Thank you.
If there's something standing in the way, let's try our best.
Thank you, dear Lord.
offense or whatever, I'd like the church to remember one of the sisters of prayer. Not talking about his sister. I got a sister-in-law that needs your prayers. She got bad news today. So one good thing, she can tell my wife. She didn't want to leave her family, but she knows what she's doing. She's got to remember her and Melinda. Burden down more than not. We'll be praying for
her. What is she driving me?
It's your heart.
Wait for Janie now.
Is this road